Our starting point for the logistic equation is the simple model that I discussed in the last video, f of p equals rp. This has the rather unrealistic feature that populations grow without bound. The world would be completely taken over by rabbits in the previous example. We know that's not the case because we can move about the world without hitting rabbits. So we know that in general, populations don't grow forever. So we'd like to modify this in some simple way to account for the fact that there's going to be some limit to the number of rabbits or whatever it is we're studying. So we'll do that by adding a term to this equation. So I've modified this equation by adding this term 1 minus p over a. The quantity a is known as an annihilation population. If the rabbits ever reach this population a, the next year there'll be no rabbits. So this must be some level such that the rabbits would eat all their food or fight with each other so badly that the next year there'll be no rabbits. So a is an annihilation population. You could also think of it as an apocalypse population. It's, if we ever reach this population, the next year there'll be no more rabbits. So let me show you that statement algebraically. If the population equals A, all the rabbits die. So let's see how that would work. So the question is, what's f of A? Remember that this function tells you the population next year if you know the population is p the current year. So if the population is A, then f of A would give the population the next year. So let's plug in and see what happens. So I have R. I'm plugging in A for p. A over A is 1. One minus one is 0. And RA times 0 is 0. So indeed, if there, the population reaches A, there'll be no rabbits the next year. So A is the annihilation population or the apocalypse population. There's another property of this equation that I want to mention that I think makes sense. And that is, if the population is small, then it'll look, it's very close to the original model we studied. So let me write that out. So for small populations, we're very far away from the apocalypse or the annihilation, we should see the rapid growth that we saw earlier. It's only when p gets to be large that the rabbits start to run out of food or are competing with each other for space or something that the population growth might start to slow down. So first, I should say what I mean by small. By small, I mean that p is much less than a. P is much less than a. And if that's the case, p over a is approximately 0. So maybe a is 10,000. 10,000 rabbits is the apocalypse number. And p might be 10 or 20. 10 or 20 over 10,000 is a very small number. It's close to 0. When that's the case, p over a is close to 0. So 1 minus something close to 0 is close to 1. This will be just a little bit less than 1. So this term in parentheses here is around 1. So this equation just becomes Rp. So for small populations, this logistic equation, this is a logistic equation. The population will grow rapidly, like the rabbit example from the previous video. But then once the population gets large, this term starts to matter, and the population growth will slow down. And there's some absolute upper limit, an annihilation or apocalypse number, at which the population will completely crash. So these two properties, I hope, seem reasonable for a simple model whose only goal is to have some limit to the rapid growth. So next, I'll plot this equation. I'll plot this function of p, and we'll interpret it graphically. So the logistic equation is in this form. F of p is rp times 1 minus p over a. And this equation, when iterated, would just describe the growth of a population. So the idea is, down here, so I'm gonna plot this function. On the horizontal axis, I'll have pn, the population this year. And on the vertical axis, this function tells me what the population will be next year. So this next year's population, you could call it f of p, or pn plus 1. So let's make a quick sketch of this function. And it turns out that it looks like this. It's an upside down parabola. Okay. So obviously just a rough sketch, but let's see what it tells us. The population is small, so down here the population is small, then we have population growth. So these units are arbitrary. If I'm at one unit here, then the population the next year would be 2. So we're about doubling. If I'm at 2, then the population the next year might be very roughly 4. So for here, for small population, the population is small, we have pretty rapid growth. Here, if we're at the annihilation or apocalypse population, so we have a very large population this year, the purple curve, the function, goes through 0, so that means there'll be 0 rabbits the next year, so hence annihilation or apocalypse. And if we're close to this value, they'll be close to 0 the next time. So say if I'm here, I'm very close to the maximum value, the apocalypse value. Then what's my population next year? I would go up here. The height of the graph tells me it'll be quite small. So as we approach the apocalypse value, the population is going to get smaller. So in any event, the logistic equation, here it is. It looks like this. We'll see graphs of this again. It is a simple model designed to capture population growth where there's some limiting factor to the population. So it can't grow forever. There's some maximum value that it, if it ever reaches, you suddenly lose all the population. I'll complete the derivation of the logistic equation by simplifying this equation a little bit and putting it in a slightly different and more standard and I think more general form. So here's the logistic equation, rp times 1 minus p over a. A is the annihilation population and r is a growth parameter. And this tells me the population next year if I know the population this year. So let me write that in a slightly different way. Pn plus 1, the population next year, is r times pn times 1 minus pn over a. So to simplify things a little bit, make this p look a little better. Sorry, that's a bit of a mess. So to simplify things a little bit, I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by a. So I'm going to divide this by a, and I'm going to divide this by a. Mathematically, that's a legal move. I'm allowed to divide both sides of the equation by a, as long as a isn't 0, which it won't be. That will preserve the inequality. And then notice I've got a p over a, a p over a, and a p over a, and that will let me simplify things a little bit. So I'm going to define a new variable x as follows. So I'll define this new variable x as p divided by a. It's the population, but expressed as a fraction of the annihilation population. So if x equals 0.5, that means we're halfway to the annihilation or apocalypse value. We're halfway to the maximum possible number. If x is 0.8, then we're 80% of the way. If x is 0.1, we're just 10% of a. So x then is a number that's always between 0 and 1. I can use this x to write this equation in a simpler form. P over A is x. P over A is x. P over A is x. So this tells me that next year's population is equal to rx times 1 minus x, where x is the population expressed as a fraction of this maximum possible value. Let me write this as a function as well. The function we'll be working with that we'll be iterating a lot in the next couple subunits is just this. F of x is rx 1 minus x. So this is the logistic equation in the standard form that we'll work with. It's important enough that I'll put a red box around it. And just for completeness, R is a growth rate parameter. So R is something that will vary, will change, and we'll see how the behavior of this equation changes. And lastly, I can expand or multiply out the right-hand side of this. Doing so, I would get this, Rx minus Rx squared. So the logistic equation is just a second-order polynomial. It's a parabola. It's a very simple function. Something you've studied parabolas in high school for sure. It's not an exotic or complicated function at all. So in the next several subunits, we'll start iterating this function and we'll see what the properties of the function are. And I'll end this lecture with just a quick example before you try one on your own. Let me do a quick example just to review the idea of iterating a function. So I'll iterate the logistic equation, and I'll let r equals 1.5. So the function I'll be working with is f of x is 1.5x, 1 minus x. I need to choose a seed. So I'll say, I don't know, let's see what happens if x naught is 0.2. So then the first iterate is obtained by applying the function to the seed. So that's 1.5 times 0.2 times 1 minus 0.2. So I'll do that on a calculator. Let's see here. And I get 0.24. Okay, so then the next iterate is f applied to 0.24, which is 1.5, 0.24, 1 minus 0.24. Let's do that on a calculator. And I get 0.2736. And we can keep going and going. We get the next iterate, the next value in the orbit, by applying the function. So we can apply this function again and again to a seed, and then we can ask what its long-term behavior is. We'll do that in the next subunit. Before you do so, I suggest doing the quiz that follows this lecture just to make sure you see how this goes.